Well, in the news today, over 30,000 farmers in Maharashtra are marching on the streets, their destination, Vidhan Bhavan, the seat of power in Maharashtra. Timed to coincide with the state's budget session, angry farmers plan to garrow the assembly and demand the government act on its promises. The Fadnavis government's failure to implement the proposed farm loan waiver is allegedly in time is one of the top issues on the Kisan's agendas. They've also raised the compensation that was promised in the recent hailstorm in the state. The state had announced a 200 crore rupee relief package for farmers who were affected that hasn't reached them yet in Maharashtra. And of course, as those farmers marched towards the state budget was presented today in the budget session. Our correspondent Disha was at the state budget and is live with us right now. Disha, what were the announcements that were made in the state budget specific to do with farmers? And why are the farmers so unhappy?
That's right, Faye. This year around, also when we talk about Maharashtra state budget, it was an agriculture-centric budget, which was like last year. And this time around, what we understand is that there are again slew of provisions and schemes that the government has launched this time also around, if a couple of three related to farmers, of course. First, we talk about the horticultural scheme that has been extended to the farmers who have land less than six hectares in rest of Maharashtra, including Konkan. In fact, also they have made a provision of rupees 750 crores for electrification of agriculture pump sets, and also provision of 50 crores for Chief Minister Agriculture and Food Processing Scheme. So all of these are provisions which every now and then, Faye, are done in the state budget. The government allocates, and this time around also highest allocation has been given to the agriculture sector. But still at the end of the day, the farmers are really unhappy because they are still demanding loan waiver. But they are still waiting for the loan waiver from the government. Not only loan waiver, but even crop insurance for that matter, 50% of crop insurance. And that's the only reason when we also spoke exclusively to the Minister of State, Agriculture Minister, as to what is the plan of action, because out of 1.3 crore farmers in the state of Maharashtra, only 35 lakh farmers have been given loan waiver till now in the past 2 years. So this number and the remaining number of farmers are still waiting for that. So when we spoke to the Minister of Agriculture concerned of Maharashtra, he went on to say that they have a target of giving loan waiver at least to 70 lakh farmers till 2019, and in the next 3 to 4 months the government is planning to disburse over 10 crore rupees in the bank accounts of almost 15 to 20 lakh farmers. So this is what the government has in the agenda, and despite that, we know for the fact there were various schemes, and when we also spoke to the ex-chief minister of Maharashtra, Prithviraj Chauhan, concerned, Faye, he went on to say that all these schemes, why the farmers are unhappy, is only because the schemes of be it the crop insurance or be it the schemes, they do not even reach farmers at the end of the day. So most of the farmers are not being able to gain or avail the benefit.
In fact, Disha Shah caught up with the Maharashtra Agriculture Minister about the government's plan to to manage this loan crisis. And as Disha was telling us, the minister told her very clearly that they plan to move 10,000 crore rupees into the into the bank accounts of various farmers, and they target 70 lakh farmers over the next 1 year before 2019. Disha, obviously, let's go across and listen to that interaction between Disha and the minister from earlier this afternoon.
फिगर्स की बात की जाए, 35 लाख फार्मर्स को मिले हैं अभी पिछले और एक साल में, और कितने फार्मर्स का ऐसे ये है टारगेट है कि इतने फार्मर्स तक हमको ये लोन वेवर पहुंचाना है?
नहीं, अभी वो 70 लाख फार्मर्स का टारगेट है, वो टारगेट इस साल में तो पूरा करेगी, और बजट में तो कम खर्चने के लिए पैसा कम पड़ेगा तो पुरानी मांग से वो पैसा उपलब्ध करके किसानों को दे जाएगा।
और अभी सर मंडे को 30,000 से ज्यादा फार्मर्स आने वाले हैं यहाँ पे विधान भवन में प्रोटेस्ट करने के लिए, डिमांड ये रखने के लिए कि लोन वेवर और क्रॉप इंश्योरेंस जो 50% गवर्नमेंट देती है, तो तभी गवर्नमेंट का क्या रिस्पॉन्स होगा फार्मर्स को जो यहाँ पे एकदम पूरे कंट्री पूरे अलग अलग शहरों से आ रहे हैं यहाँ पे प्रोटेस्ट करने?
नहीं, इस राज्य ने पहले ही किसानों को उतनी कर्ज माफी दी, उतनी कर्ज माफी इस राज्य के इतिहास में कभी नहीं दी थी। जो कर्ज माफी किसानों को दी थी वो केंद्र सरकार ने दिए थे, राज्य सरकार ने नहीं दी थी। और ज्यादा से ज्यादा अभी 30 करोड़ से ज्यादा कर्ज माफी का पैसा किसानों के खाते में डाल दिया है। अभी जो किसान बाकी है उसको भी दी जाएगी और कई लोग
कब तक दी जाएगी सर, टाइमलाइन क्या रखा है इस चीज के?
वो अभी 3-4 महीना में बहुत ज्यादा उनके खाते में पैसे जमा हो जाएंगे उसका सब।
3-4 महीने में क्या अमाउंट सोचा है?
अमाउंट तो मुझे लगता है कि कम से कम अभी 30 करोड़ तक दी गए हैं, अभी 10 करोड़ तक उसका अमाउंट हो जाएगी।
कितने फार्मर्स को?
अभी मुझे लगता है कि अभी 50 टका फार्मर्स जो अर्ज आए थे उसके ऊपर अभी खाते में पैसा जमा हुआ, अभी 10 से 15 लाख फार्मर्स को खाते में जमा हो जाएगी।
Well, right now we also have joining us at this point Mirror Now's senior editor Mandar Fansi, who's at Sahapur with the farmers who are marching on foot to Mumbai. Sahapur is nearly 40 kilometers outside of Mumbai. Richa joins us as well. She's looking at the minimum support price that was supposed to be given to farmers and how much of that has actually been has actually been actioned. But first I'm going to go across to Mandar. Mandar, tell us what these farmers are saying to you at this point. Disha was telling us, the Maharashtra government seems confident about its farm loan waiver. It is said that it has already, compensated 35 lakh farmers, and they're going to get to everybody in the next 1 year. Is that not enough for the farmers? What are the farmers demanding at this point, Mandar?
Absolutely, a kind of distress you can very well see over here amongst the farmers who have gathered here from all across the North Maharashtra tribal belt, especially because as we know, this particular farmers gathering is all across from the Jalgaon, Dhule, Nandurbar, Nasik and Palghar districts by now, and even part of the farmers from the tribal belt of Thane district also have gathered here as of now. Around this is a massive gathering of farmers, and around almost 30,000-35,000 farmers have gathered around here at the bank of this Bhatsa river, which is situated at Sahapur. You can see the faces over here. They are looking tired, but they are really having that kind of a resolve on their face, which is very much evident. And at the same time, all the preparations are going on. They are still waiting to reach out to Mumbai and basically highlight their demands to the government, where the government is already meeting on a session. The assembly session is on. I can just give a glimpse of some of the feelings of the people gathered over here. Mausi, काय किती चाललात आतापर्यंत, कितपत चाललात, कुठून कुठून आलात तुम्ही?
कुठपर्यंत आला? आता गावाचं नाव
नाशिकवरून।
नाशिक म्हणजे कुठे? दिंडोरी, नाशिक?
नाशिक, नाशिक।
थकले का?
मग थकलो तो, मग
भरपूर थकले,
भरपूर।
अजून जाणार पुढपर्यंत? मुंबईपर्यंत जाणार?
मुंबईपर्यंत।
कुठली शेती कुठली आहे तुमची?
नाळेगाव।
शेती काय, शेती काय करता?
गायरान।
भात तुम्ही वन ऑफ वन ऑफ वन ऑफ वन ऑफ द member over here, they are giving more details to us, Faye and Mausi. काय कुठले?
Why is it?
आमची नागली वरय खुरासनी भात नागलीची शेती राहते, आमची वरचे पिकाची वरचे पाण्याची, आणि आमची पलाट आहे त्यानावर झाले पाहिजे, 7-12 उतारा भेटले पाहिजे आम्हाला। एवढा लांबून आम्ही नाशिक पासूनही बरेच अंतरीवर आमचा गाव आहे।
मी तुमचं सांगतो तुम्ही काय म्हटलं ते। बेसिकली
All these demands, these are all largely farmers who are dependent on the paddy and millet crops, and obviously these particular two crops are not giving them anything substantial. And apart from that, obviously they are all demanding those forest lands which are on the outskirts of the forest, and they are tilling those lands for years together, and those lands according to the act are supposed to be transferred in their name, but those lands are not yet transferred in their name. And largely these farmers who have gathered from all across the Satpura ranges in the North Maharashtra, they are demanding these lands which are the forest lands, and as per the new act and as per the details of the act, those lands are supposed to be transferred to these villagers. You can see, which is very much evident now, the almost the party has started there. The various local tribal music have also started being played, and as of now, apart from these particular farmers, there are Raigad district farmers, there are Thane district farmers who are, and Palghar district farmers, like three more districts possibly would join this particular congregation, and around expected crowd will be 45,000-50,000 odd crowd will be there when it this crowd will reach by Monday morning in Mumbai. Faye.
Well, Mandar, also if you could speak to some of the farmers, we understand the hailstones or the hailstorms that we've had in the state of Maharashtra has caused considerable damage to crops, crops from oranges to grapes. We know that Maharashtra has large amounts of land that's actually dedicated to growing fruit, and that has been, that has seen you know, a lot of damage this year. The eco survey that was released for the state of Maharashtra yesterday said that agricultural produce has gone down. And Maharashtra has always been a very proud farming state. So if you could bring us some personal stories of how people have suffered because of the, you know, because of changes in weather, or how they've suffered because their farm, you know, loan waivers have been delayed. Why are they individually? So obviously there is, the, you know, there's an association that has brought them together. But individually, what kind of pain are these farmers going through? Why have they, you know, been motivated to go on to this, this journey on foot?
Of course, the basic motivation is that hope, basically, because nothing has been really giving them substantial growth in terms of their own living, and at the same time, whatever crop they are expecting to get back through the MSPs and various schemes which have been already promised by the state government, as of now, these people are not hopeful about that particular situation. I can just ask a few of the young men over here, काय कुठले तुम्हाला आता जी परिस्थिती काय, म्हणजे शेतीची परिस्थिती काय, आता जे गारपीट झाली त्या वेळेला नेमकं काय झालं होतं, तुम्हाला काही मदत मिळाले काय? वाना
नाही नाही.
कुठली शेती आहे तुमची?
द्राक्ष, टमाटे, वांगे, कोबी.
आता मी एकटा नाही, माझे भाजीपाला करतो.
एकरी एकरी तुम्हाला काहीतरी यावेला, जेव्हा आता कर्जबाज हे झाली, कर्जमुक्ती झाली, त्याचं काही तुम्हाला मिळालं का? तुमच्याकडे काही अकाउंट पर्यंत पोहोचलं का? काय तुमची काय अपेक्षा?
कर्ज माफी व्हावे, लाईट बिल माफ व्हावे, असे शेतकऱ्याच्या बऱ्याचशा समस्या आहेत. पूर्ण
का माफ व्हायचं? माफ कशाला करायला पाहिजे? तुम्हाला काही उत्पन्न देत नाही, मिळत नाही का अजिबात?
आम्ही भाऊ माल केला तर त्याला मार्केट नाही भेटत. कोणते वांगे केले तर 10 रुपये जाळी, 20 रुपये जाळी, भाड्यात पैसे जातात. ते काय करणार? भाड्यात द्यायचे गाडीवाल्याला का? ते बियाणे घ्यायचे, ते महाग झाले.
बियाणे तुम्ही म्हणत होता गव्हाचं, आता काय परिस्थिती आहे गव्हाच्या? ह्याच्यासाठी तुम्हाला आधारभूत किंमत, मिनिमम सपोर्ट प्राइस मिळते, तसं काय होतं?
ते का जशी क्वालिटी गव्हाची तसा भाव मिळतो, 1600-1700 रुपये असं क्विंटल भाव मिळतो. जमतेम 25-26-27 असं क्विंटलला भाव मिळला पाहिजे.
As he is really explaining about his plights, about the total output which finally they are getting through the harvested crop is not that great a return. I was talking to most of those people, they were also complaining about the quality of seeds, the quality of the fertilizers. Everything is going sky high in terms of the prices, and apart from these prices, obviously the returns are not as expected as they should get. But obviously this is what is the reason
why they are all here, and at the same time they are almost traveled to 80 kilometers so far, and 60-70 odd kilometers still they are resolved to go till the assembly session of Maharashtra assembly. That means obviously everybody here is having that kind of a resolve to get something in return, and this is almost a test of state government, Maharashtra government especially, when they will be facing this much of crowd for the first time possibly in Mumbai.
Rimanda, stay with us because I want you to also comment on Richa's findings. Richa, from what I understand, is at Jalna, where she's taking a look at the procurement. Now, this is important because we know that the central government announced a procurement policy with a minimum support price during the budget, which is why the union budget was touted in February as a farmer's budget. Now, if this had to work out, then the current Rabi crop that is being procured should have been received with great happiness from all of our farmers, but that's not what we're seeing. So Richa has actually traveled out to Jalna to find out what is really going on. Are the farmers receiving their minimum support price? Richa, what have you found?
That's right, Faye. The situation on ground is extremely different from what was, promised by the central government in this year's budget. We spoke to a number of these farmers on field, in fact, while they were farming, to know if they are getting any kind of benefits from this MSPs that have been announced. But it does not seem to be the case. We also went to the Jalna Procurement Centre, which has been recently started earlier this year, to find out if the farmers are happy with this whole situation. But it does not seem so, because compared to last year's prices of the MSPs that were announced, this year it is not very different. The only increase or the bonus amount that they have added is of a minimum price of 100 or 200 rupees. This does not account to 50% or at least 1.5 times of what the government has been claiming. And let me tell you, Faith, the amount of farmers who are getting a benefit of MSP is very low. At least more than 90% of these farmers still go to the local markets to sell their goods, because they are afraid that the government will not pay them back in time. And this is certainly the case. We have got on camera farmers talking about the fact that for at least 1 month or more than a month, they have to wait for the checks to come in from the government, and this is the reason that they have no other option but to go to the private vendors or private owners, who in fact give them cash in hand immediately. So these are the various problems that the farmers are facing specifically to the MSP issue, because clearly the promises that have been made in this year's budget as well, it is not clearly reflecting on ground here in Jalna.
Richa, thanks so much for that update. Stay with us, and I just want to point out to our viewers the footage that you're looking at on your screen right now, with live visuals coming in from the farmers who are protesting. Remember, Miranao has been on the road with these farmers. They began their 180-kilometer journey, their march on Wednesday from CBS Chowk in central Nasik, and they're not all from Nasik. They've come into Nasik from across the state. This is where they've camped for tonight. At Sahapur, this is about 40 kilometers outside of Mumbai, this is New India, really. The cell phones that you see, there's tribal music being played, like Mandar told us, and the farmers have all gotten together. But we have to remind you, viewers, that these farmers will be in the city of Mumbai on Monday, perhaps a little before that. 30,000 farmers in the state government better be prepared, because they're going to walk through the city of Mumbai to Mantralay, where they plan to ghero Mantralay. Remember, they've been walking through Igatpuri, Sahapur, Bhiwandi, Thane, and they're expected to reach Mumbai on Monday, the 12th of March, where they will go to Mantralay and ghero the Vidhan Sabha. Mandar is with us right now. Mandar, if you could hear what the report that Richa was bringing us from the Jalna Procurement Center, and you've been tracking this for decades, so nobody understands this better than you do. What went wrong from the government's promises during the union budget of 1.5 times to the farmers that are now surrounding you at Sahapur, where they're unhappy with procurement? Richa tells us that not enough of them are actually benefiting from the announcement of minimum support price in the budget. So what went wrong? Where did we miss? Where did we go wrong, really, with our farmers this year?
Pardon me, Faye, please repeat again your question, because there's a lot of commotion over here, and We just try to gather what you're talking about. Your question, please.
All right. So, Madam, my question to you is, the minimum support price for procurement has not been delivered to these farmers as promised.
So, as I gathered about the pricing, your question, Faye, basically, if we talk around with these farmers and even the farmers across the rest of Maharashtra and Marathwada, especially right now, almost 170 odd various procurement centers have started in Maharashtra, especially when it comes to the Rabi harvest. Right now, the gram varieties, various gram varieties, and the Tuvar variety is being supposed to be procured by state government, but the state government is very slow while procuring all these things. Apart from that, the kind of promise which was made in the central budget, that promise about giving 1.5 times more than the MSP in return to the farmers is also not being fulfilled for sure on the ground, and that's why unrest in the farmers, and obviously the distress is also very much so, which is quite evident by the economic survey figures, which has gone down -8.3. that is the agricultural situation. It's a dismal situation of a state like Maharashtra.
I'm going to leave you there, because we're going to come back to this story at prime time tonight at 9 p.m. but in the meantime, Mandar, Disha and Richa, thank you so much for bringing us those details to help us understand this problem better, because it's so important for us as people who live in the cities to understand what our farmers are going through. So this sort of reportage is important in modern India. We're going to leave it right there. We'll come back with a special bulletin on what's happening with the cricketer Mohammad Shami and why this story is so big in India today. That's on the other side. Don't go anywhere.